Every year, the American Red Cross chooses just a handful of Red Cross real heroes.
Kathleen O'Toole introduces us to this year's winners in the law enforcement category. Tonight, meet two men who jumped in to save another man's life.
Born and raised in Lantana, Travis Keene is at home on Lake Osborne in a spot nestled just beyond the airport.
You're kind of used to hearing the planes all day long, you know, on the lake because it's so close to the airport.
But the sound of engines didn't stop Travis from camping on the lake last Easter weekend.
We are always pulling people or boats or something out of the water.
A little to the south, Deputy Baron Miller was on patrol.
The call came out that there was a plane crash.
Just kind of thought to myself, you know, this can't be happening now. You know, I got my son with me.
I could see the tail of the plane first sticking out of the water. It looked like the plane was underwater, sinking quickly.
So my first thought was, you know, we got to go now.
I started heading towards him. He threw his anchor out and jumped in the water, swam over to me.
So I thought the best plan of attack would be for me to get up on the boat so we could work together.
Actually, working together is something they've done for years with PBSO's Marine Patrol.
Marine 11, man.
It just so happens it was Travis's day off.
Travis was able to reach in, use a knife, and cut the shoulder harnesses off of the guy.
We pulled and pulled and pulled, and the guy wouldn't come out.
Inside was pilot Michael Capioli, who had just been making repairs to his experimental plane. The plane nosedived and was now upright 12 feet underwater, his head less than 4 inches from the surface, while Travis struggled with the final belt holding him in.
After we pulled him out, I looked back. The plane had completely submerged.
Travis started CPR as they raced to the shore to waiting paramedics.
This is the actual site.
3 months later, the spot of the impact is still marked, feet away from a cross that holds the memory of a man who made his mark on them.
You can help us honor our heroes. Seats are still available for the luncheon on June 23rd. The celebration will be held at the Kravis Center in West Palm Beach. Call the number that's right here on your screen or look for Red Cross Real Heroes under As Seen on 25 on WPBF.com.